Welcome to my talk about the Knowledge Compilation Challenge for Variability. My name is Thomas Thüm, and this work is presented at the Software Product Line Conference. So let me start with introducing what is common to the product line community. So the product line community or product line technology is basically enabled and powered by set problems, right? So what is common is that a certain analysis is reduced to a set problem or a set of set problems. And this has been done for feature models, so for like pure configuration spaces, but also connected to code. So any program analysis can be lifted to a product line in a systematic way, but in the end, it's all about producing set problems that are to be solved. And it's common sense that, or commonly accepted knowledge, that like the set problems that we see in the product line community are easy to solve, right? So it takes you a number of milliseconds or seconds, but then you will have the result. So which kind of solvers are used in the community? This study here shows something for at least like a sub-community, that of interaction testing, that in most cases SAT solvers are used, but there's a large number of other solvers that have been used. And it's actually good that people started many years ago to use SAT solving technology, and this is illustrated by the following study that appeared this year. And it's called the time leap challenge. So what does it mean? So it means like we want to understand how much of the speed up that current SAT technology has comes from the hardware or from the algorithm design, right? So what these people did is they compared like 20-year-old hardware with new algorithms and compared it with new hardware and 20-year-old algorithms. And they found about similar results, so similar speedups, a bit in favor of new algorithms. So like the innovation in algorithms and software was a bit higher than that in hardware. But it's interesting to see that it's not only good to build on this, like if we just wait a couple of years, let's say 10 or 20 years, it's not only that we have faster machines, but also we have smarter algorithms, right? If we would build all these algorithms on our own, then we would not only have the speed up of the hardware. So, but then what is the next big thing to work on, right? So what is the holy grail for the product line community? So what to focus on in the next 10 or 20 years? And when I'm at conferences and talking to people, I found out that many PhD students are actually working on the same topic, but cannot get it published because they did not succeed in what they did. So what they tried is they wanted to create a BDD for Linux, so binary decision diagram. So that's why I argue that BDD for Linux is a challenging excuse, so the holy grail, if you want so, because it's both beneficial and challenging, and I want to show you why. So first of all, binary decision diagrams are more than 20 years old, more than 30 years old. They go back to Bryant. And here is one small example. So what you do is you can basically encode any propositional formula into a graph data structure. So with any, I mean any in principle, in theory. I will come to that in a minute. So the idea is we have nodes for each variable. And if you select it, you go to the right. If you do not select it, you have the false edge, which goes to the left. And you do this until you reach one of the bottom elements, which is either 0 or 1, 1 indicating that you found a satisfiable assignment for this variable, for this formula. So why are BDDs so beneficial? So why do we want to have them? So what you can see is it takes a constant operation to find out whether a BDD is satisfiable or not. You simply need to see whether the node indicated with 1 is connected to other nodes or not. And there are other queries like computing the number of satisfiable assignments, which are easy to compute for BDDs. the problem and the challenge with BDDs is that they are heavily depend on the order of variables. So the right-hand side shows an encoding of the same formula, but with a different variable encoding, and we see that kind of explodes, right? So we have a lot more variables in the BDD, and that's the challenge that is faced by the community when people want to apply it to large configuration spaces. Nevertheless, BDDs are good because they are fast on the queries that we want to compute once we have such a BDD, and the further advantage if we want to solve several SAT problems with the same BDD. BDDs have been used for many applications. Here, just an overview on the first applications that have been done with BDDs in the product line field. So, for instance, product configuration. So, if you want to compute which features are available during configuration process, then to detect model inconsistencies in model-based development has been done. And it has also been used in comparison with other solvers to find out whether it's efficient to compute certain operations, for instance, computing the number of valid configurations. So, but all these research papers are nice and novel, but it's interesting to understand whether they scale to Linux or not. So, but then why Linux, right? So why not any other product line? So Linux is a very common benchmark, right? So many product line analysis have been applied to Linux, and it's typically hard to challenge, or it's challenging to scale to the size of Linux because Linux has so many features and so many constraints at the same time, right? So many applications, it's fine to work with many features if you have few constraints. You can also cope with many constraints if you have few features, but the combination of many features and many constraints is challenging. Also, Linux is one of two large product lines for which it is unknown what is the number of valid configurations. And this number is not only interesting for our community to know, but it's essential to be able to compute this for many different algorithms, such as sampling. So many of the current sampling algorithms do not scale to Linux, for instance. But of course, there are other large product lines beyond Linux. And one of the other models for which we in previous work were not able to compute the number of valid configurations was an industrial product line. Unfortunately, it's not yet publicly available. We are working on that, but in the meantime, you can work on Linux, but there are also many other large product lines. I just want to bring your attention to one example, which is the Gentoo distribution. So it's a derivative of Linux, but it comes with a very variability-rich package manager. And there's this recent study from this year at ICSI that showed that there are actually 670,000 features. Of course, this number needs to be treated a bit with care because there are duplicates among those features. But still, it's a high number, and it's unclear how to deal with that. Besides large feature models, there's different kind of knowledge compilation techniques beyond BDDs, right? So there's this knowledge compilation map that is now about 20 years old. And these techniques that are shown in the map, some are much older than that, but like there's quite some research on knowledge compilation. So what does knowledge compilation mean? So the idea is you invest some offline computation and you derive a representation, kind of you compile the knowledge into representation that makes further queries more efficient. And this is especially beneficial for product lines where we have to not only have solve several SAT problems for a single analysis. For instance, when type checking Linux, we have about a million SAT problems to solve. But in addition, we have several different analyses that are typically applied on the same product line version. And then we also have different versions, right? So we have a huge number of SAT problems to solve, and it could be much more efficient, and that's up to further research, to show what benefit can we have if we compile the data into a data structure. And then there are several examples here so to focus on, and BDDs are not the only representation, but one very famous one. So what is the goal of the challenge? To make aware of scalability problems. Obviously, we have them, right? So some of the techniques do not scale to all configuration spaces. To avoid redundant efforts. So I mentioned that like unsuccessful efforts are typically not published, and therefore we have redundant effort going on, right? So it's the idea is to also to avoid that. To maybe have an exchange on solutions, right? Even like intermediate solutions, to join forces to see who else is working on this, to promote knowledge compilation, because I think this is one of the big things that we will see a lot in the next like 10 or 20 years in research, and to advance the state of the analysis in terms of product line analysis. So what's in the scope of this challenge? Of course, knowledge compilation, not only BDDs, large-scale configuration spaces, not only Linux. Also partial and older models, because typically we have like smaller versions and they're easier to cope with. And then there's incremental knowledge compilation, which means after an evolution step, I don't have to start from scratch, but I can reuse part of the effort. And then there might be under or over approximations, meaning that we take a subset of the constraints of Linux and model it, for instance. And then, of course, unsuccessful attempts. That's it for the presentation of the knowledge compilation challenge for variability. And I'm looking forward for your feedback, so just send me an email, or I'm also interested to see how we can cope with this massive problem. And ideally, we can work on this together to make this happen. Thank you.